This video is sponsored by Skillshare. The first 500 people to go to skl.sh/polyphonic27 will get 2 months of learning free. One of the first times I really thought about music, thought about it in the way that I do all the time on this channel at least, happened all the way back in 2007. The world was melting, mass media was fracturing public discourse, and America was mired in imperialistic wars in the Middle East.
That's all still happening.
Being 13 at the time, I was ignorant to most of this. But then I got an assignment in my music class. We needed to pick one of our favorite songs and do a presentation on it. The song I chose? BYOB by System of a Down. I knew that song was a protest song, but at the time I didn't understand just how political it was. And I didn't understand that it was part of a socially conscious album packed with songs of resistance. Let's take a closer look. System of a Down released Mezmerize and Hypnotize 6 months apart from each other, but the albums were written and recorded at the same time. Because of that, I'm going to be referring to them together as one double album throughout the rest of this video. And that album is a wild ride. It's got explosive highs and quiet lows, moments of near religious triumph next to pure surrealism, reggae breakdowns smashed in the middle of thrash metal jams. And all throughout, it's packed to the brim with anti-war messaging. This message is made clear in the song that bookends the album, Soldier Side.
People all grow up to die.
The first version of Soldier Side is a slow, simple song that sets the tone. It's a scene of loneliness and death. These themes of death permeate the entire album, hanging over the music like a specter. After Soldier Side has set this dark tone, we're thrown into BYOB, a furious protest song that looks at war from a perspective of class.
Why do they always set the bar? Why do they always set the bar? Why do they always set the bar?
Why do they always set the bar?
While BYOB speaks to the universal truths of war, it's also steeped in imagery that's more specific to the Iraq War and the War on Terror, deserts and oil in particular. The bridge even discusses fascism, a regular talking point around George W. Bush's governmental policies during the war in Iraq.
Blast off! It's party time! And we don't live in a fascist nation!
But BYOB isn't exclusively about war. It also introduces the biggest theme of the album as a whole, propaganda. This is made explicitly clear in the video, which is steeped in dystopian imagery. One of the staples of System of a Down's lyricism is irony, something on display in the chorus of BYOB.
Everybody's going to the party, have a real good time.
By describing the war in Iraq as a party, System of a Down reveal how propaganda downplayed the severity of a war that would cause more than 100,000 civilian deaths. In the song's violent refrain, Serge Tankian shouts, "Where the fuck are you?" This shows the way governments pressure people to support them. If you're not coming to the party, you're not a patriot. System of a Down were big on the concept of groupthink, and particularly the way it was used to encourage American citizens to support an unjust war. UFIG explores this concept further. The way governments are able to inspire this mob mentality and get people to join unjust wars is through the use of propaganda. That's where the album's titles come from. Propaganda is able to either hypnotize you into supporting war or mesmerize you enough that you can ignore what's happening altogether. Fittingly, the condemnation of propaganda is most explicit on the title track of Hypnotize.
Propaganda leaves us blinded.
The opening lines of that song talk about the aesthetics of resistance, with a comparison to one of the most famous protest movements in modern history.
Why don't you ask the kids at Tiananmen Square?
In our modern capitalist world, the aesthetics of unity and resistance are co-opted and used to sell products, to sell an identity. But while Hypnotize takes on high-concept political ideas, it also seeks to reach the common man. In an interview with Revolver, Darren Malakian talked about the song's chorus. "I see us as a socially conscious band, not just a political band. The guy sitting in his car, waiting for his girl, with the world going on around him. It comes down to that. One of the ways that System of a Down are able to appeal to the average person is through humor. This is probably most clear in Cigar.
My cock is much bigger than yours!
My cock can walk right through that door!
And while Cigarro seems to be a crude, surrealist humor piece on the surface, it too contains a political message. In an AMA on Reddit, Serge Tankian said Cigarro was based on a Dick Cheney-like character. Cigarro is a parody of the egotism that runs rampant in both corporate circles and federal politics. As we get deeper into Cigarro, we get a scathing condemnation of Cheney and his like, showing how the rich and powerful use the world as their plaything.
We're the propagators of all genocide, burning through the world's resources that we can't hide.
The fallout of this behavior can be seen in Tentative, a song that depicts a society on the brink.
We're going down in a spiral to the ground.
And while Tentative talks about society on a broad scale, Sad Statue takes the same image and places it squarely within the United States.
And we will all go down in history with a sad statue of liberty. And
the Statue of Liberty once represented hope and freedom, but the band posit that the symbol is now associated with an imperialist propaganda state. The Statue of Liberty is a particularly potent symbol for System of a Down to use, as the band is made up of immigrants. All of System of a Down come from Armenian heritage, and three of them were born outside of the United States. Holy Mountains even touches on these roots, singing about the Armenian genocide, where more than a million Armenians were systematically killed by the Ottoman Empire. One of the oldest propaganda tactics in the book is to target immigrants and ethnic minorities. This creates an in-group mentality. These people aren't like us. And you can use this mentality to justify all kinds of atrocity. In the War on Terror, this played itself out as Islamophobia, and in the modern age, xenophobia is being used more than ever to stoke the fires of hatred. Attack is System of a Down's rally cry against this world of divisive propaganda.
We attack the years of propaganda!
The answer to this propaganda is unity and solidarity. Something System of a Down sing about in both the chorus of Attack and the desperate bridge of Sad Statue.
What is in us that turns a devil to the cries of human suffering?
At the end of the album, we get a final vision of where this world has taken us as we return to the soldier side.
Dead men lying on the bottom of the grave.
System of a Down's vision of modern America is bleak. They depict it as a place where propaganda rules, either distracting people from the government's atrocities or rallying people in patriotic support of them. They depict a world where bombs fall on innocent victims, where soldiers are sent out to die in the name of an uncaring government that lies to its people. When we reach the climax of Soldier Side, we reflect on the rest of the album, and we end at the same place we began.
There is no one here but me.
Mezmerize and Hypnotize aren't exclusively political albums, but politics and social consciousness are clearly a driving force behind them. Spurred into action against the government of George W. Bush and Dick Cheney, System of a Down created an album whose message has outlasted the president it was protesting. As the internet has taken over the world, issues of misinformation and propaganda are worse than ever, and America remains entangled in endless wars paid with the price of innocent lives. I loved System of a Down in middle school, and I love them even more now. They helped me become more aware of the world in my adolescence, and helped to show me the power that music can have as a tool of resistance. I had a lot of fun putting together the graphics for this video. If they've got you inspired and you want to make something similar, I recommend you check out The Art of Story, Creating Visual Narratives by Debbie Millman on Skillshare. That course will teach you to make compelling images that pair with text to convey a narrative. And if you've watched my videos, you probably know what's coming next. If you don't like that, there's thousands more courses to choose from on Skillshare. Skillshare is honestly a fantastic platform for lifelong learners and creatives of all type. Another course that I recommend highly is my friend Thomas Frank's new course on Mastering Habits. That'll teach you how to set and then achieve personal goals for yourself. So if you feel like finding a new creative pursuit or just improving your life in general, start today by going to skl.sh/polyphonic27. The first 500 people to click that link will get 2 months of Skillshare absolutely free. And after that, an annual subscription is less than $10 a month, so it's a really affordable way to improve yourself. So why not try it out? Make sure to click the link in the description to show Skillshare that I was the one who sent you.